Hello friends, myself Priyank Trivedi. As you all know, we are going through a very stressful situation, pandemic of corona. We all must be doing duty over there, whether we are the ophthalmologist or ENT specialist or dentist or pediatrician or OBGY, whichever faculty we are serving to the people, and the many things are still we don't know. I personally say that I must have read more than 200 articles about COVID-19. Still, whenever I go to the medicine department to treat the adult people, I felt little bit confused to how to handle the adult patient, to which I am not experienced for about 3 years. And it is a very dreadful situation where we see the adult patients coming, walking, or coming on the way, and suddenly they collapse just like a movie. Sudden desaturated events are very common with the COVID-19. We must be seeing that nature is not supporting to the humanity, but is now revengery to the humanity. Till now the diseases are there which are very fatal, but they were not very contagious, like tumors and HIV/AIDS. And the diseases are very contagious, are not dreadful like rhinovirus and corona. Just we got the four symptom for 3 to 4 days and got to recover after 3 to 4 days bed rest. But the disease has been come, which is very fatal and also very contagious. So let us learn few things which I got little bit and very much confused during my rounds taking at the medicine departments of the COVID-19. And I learned from the various articles, books, and my friends Hiti, Kausal, which are from the medicine departments and helped me a lot, Dr. Vishal. So let us understand what we should take care of and what are the markers we see the files, what are the reports, why they are suggesting that, and how we can quickly take up the rounds, what are the main things which we have to see when we are not from the medicine department and still we have to be focused on. So with a little bit pathophysiology and treatment, let us start. We all know COVID-19 is the coronavirus disease, CO for corona, VI for virus, D for disease, and developed in 2019, so known as COVID-19. It's shaped like the corona petal shape, S protein is there, and it attached to the ACE2 receptors in the human cells. It acts mainly on the three systems. It goes to the lungs and produces the ARDS, acute respiratory distress syndrome like pictures. It also forms microthrombi within the circulations all over the body. And third, it produces the inflammatory response, which is very much exaggerated in the body. So all three pathophysiology, we can go to the specific three tests. As it is attacking the lungs, we are doing the chest X-ray and SpO2 monitoring, so we can say that the lung status. SpO2 is very reliable but not very conclusive. For conclusive, but it is the invasive, we can take from the ABG, but for the common practice we can rely on SpO2. Second, as it is forming the microthrombi, we are doing the D-dimer. If it is isolated abnormal, suggestive of local fibrinolytic system is deranged. If it is associated with the low platelet count and abnormal PTINR, then it is suggestive of generalized. And third is the interleukin-6 and the CRP ratio, suggestive of the inflammation, interleukin-6 and CRP. Along with this, the routine reports like the total leukocyte count for the suggestive of the infection ratio, if more than 18,000 or 20,000, we can say that there is a superimposed bacterial infection, and low platelet count suggestive of the generalized thrombinolytic activity or maybe the side effects of the some drugs which are we can use. So that the routine investigation platelet count or total leukocyte count, we are doing every 48 hourly or 72 hourly to check for the response. So after seeing that three pathophysiology, and according to that three major investigation steps. Now if the patient is mild, matlab the koi symptom nahi hai usko, जस्ट उसका बिकॉज ऑफ द रिलेटिव आर केम पॉजिटिव ही ऑल्सो गेट डन द COVID-19 और मे बी माइल्ड सिम्टम जस्ट कफ कोरिजा और लो ग्रेड फीवर. सो द ट्रीटमेंट वॉट एट्स पर द रूटीन एट पर द एट प्रेजेंट प्रोटोकॉल वॉट वी आर ऑफरिंग इज जिंक एंड विटामिन सी इन द एडल्ट पेशेंट. विटामिन सी 500 mg TDS एंड जिंक 500 mg OD फॉर 7 डेज. वी कैन एड अजिथ्रोमाइसिन इफ फीवर इज देर. द रोल इज नॉट एग्जैक्टली नोन टिल नाउ बट मे बी अफेक्टिंग द एज इट इज यूजफुल इन द वायरल न्यूमोनिया. सम मेकेनिज्म मे बी देर बट इट हैज़ फाउंड वेरी वेरी इफेक्टिव. अजिथ्रोमाइसिन इज नाउ इन द रूटीन प्रैक्टिस फॉर द ओल्ड माइल्ड केसेस. If O2 requirement is there which is more than 60%, which is not maintaining on O2 prongs, we must be say that it is a patient of moderate category. So the requirement of BiPAP is there, and we are now adding the two drugs ivermectin and doxycycline as per the present protocol. Hydroxychloroquine, because of so many side effects and common side effects, as azithromycin is founding more effective, and hydroxychloroquine with azithromycin is producing ventricular fibrillations. Azithromycin is now out of practice in most of the protocol of Gujarat. Ivermectin, what is the basic mechanism of action? It says that ivermectin is inhibiting the integrin channels which is needed for the entry of the virus into the cell. So it inhibits it, and 12 mg OD is the dose which is founding very effective with the doxycycline. Doxycycline also mechanism action is till now it's not completely understood. If the BiPAP is there, must be we are ventilating this child, secondary infection are very likely, if counts are more than 12,000, so we are adding now ceftriaxone, which is the first line. If it's not responding to that after 48 hours, we can increase on the piptaz, linezolid, meropenem. If also we suspect the anaerobes and the clindamycin, and last resort teicoplanin, we can add, and we can see on the patient during the rounds. Now it is the we have seen that the for some role of anti-inflammatory or the antioxidant zinc vitamin C, some action which are inhibiting the entry of the virus like ivermectin, and some role of the bacterial infection, so we are adding antibiotics. Now in the question must be there, that there any specific drugs which inhibits viral per se is there or not. So the answer is yes, there is a drug which is known as the remdesivir. It inhibits the RNA dependent RNA polymerase enzyme. So whenever the patient with the moderate severity and in X-ray abnormality is there, like the typical sign of the COVID-19 like ground glass opacity or crazy pavement or reverse halo signs, then we are adding on the remdesivir in the moderate cases. So the another question was there in my mind, that how the score of the CORAD scoring, how they are detected by the radiology. So I came to conclusion after some reading some books that they are dividing the all 5 lobes, 3 right lobes and 2 left lobe, into the 5 categories. If the involvement of lobe is less than 5%, then it is CAT 1. If 5 to 25%, then it is 2, 25 to 50% and 3, 50 to 75% in 4, and more than 75% means 5. If 5 lobes are more than 75% involved, and this type of involvement seen in all 5 lobes, then it is known as CORAD 25, which is the maximum score. If the one lobe is involved, which is the less than 5% involvement, then it is CORAD 1. CT scan is not routinely done in government practice, but it is very widely used when the RT-PCR negative, but our signs symptoms are very much conclusive COVID-19, then private practitioner are routinely going for the CT scan. So we have seen the remdesivir, but it is not at all a very much safe drug. So it is the nephrotoxic, hepatotoxic, and the another side effect is the bone marrow suppression. So the hepatotoxic, so we must be see before starting remdesivir AST/ALT level, if it is less than 5x of upper limit, then only we can start the remdesivir. Other is the nephrotoxic, so the even chronic renal failure with the serum potassium less than 5 mEq per liter, we are not going to start the remdesivir. And the pregnant and lactating women are not we are starting. And I have seen personally very good effects in the adult patient during my COVID duties on the adult patient, but unfortunately, as the safety data are not conclusive in the children, as myself is a pediatrician, but I can't start in the children less than 12 years. Another pathophysiology we are seeing that it is producing the multiple thrombi in the circulations. Part 2, so the what are the tests? Thrombi producing, D-dimer test, which we are routinely seeing in the patient. D-dimer, how can we are see that what drugs should start and at what level? According to D-dimer level, is if it is the D-dimer level is less than 1000, then it is the good that we are very much safe. If it is more than 1000, then we have to start enoxaparin drugs. If it is 1000 to more 1000, it is moderate severity, then 40 mg, and if it is severe severity, then 1 mg per kg. Approximately adult age kg is 60 kg, so we are giving 60 mg subcutaneously. And if it is more than 1000, we have to change over to subcutaneous heparin. And if it is more than 10,000, then it must be suggested that very rapidly coagulation system is working in the body, so we have to add on aspirin and clopidogrel. So we are doing test D-dimer. As per the test, we are giving the treatment of that pathophysiology that on virus is attacking. The third system is producing the multiple inflammatory syndrome. The body's immune system goes very much activated, so we have to suppress it. For suppression, the drug is the steroids. So for that, we have to start methylprednisolone and or the dexamethasone. Methylprednisolone 1 mg per kg or dexamethasone 0.2 to 0.4 mg per kg. For that inflammatory response, we are checking by serum ferritin level, CRP level, and LDH level. So serum ferritin level is very high, CRP level is very high, and another test is the procalcitonin, which we can see that bacterial infection is very much high or not. If bacterial infection procalcitonin level is no normal, then it's rule out bacterial infection, then we are 100% conclusive that the very high CRP level is totally due to the viral infection, and it is the COVID-19 which is producing multiple inflammatory syndrome. So we have to totally aggressively start the steroids from the day one only. So these are the totally conclusive from the whatever I learned and what I am starting routinely during my practice. Stay safe. Another thing is that we are thinking about the vaccine. We really don't know that when will it come, but hopefully we can get that. And this is the thing that God is saying that typically hum agar picture movie ki language mein kahe to human ko bhagwan ne uski aukaat dikha di hai. So we are totally helpless, worthless when I am seeing the patient in front of him came 15 minutes before, ekdam totally come in the walking state talking to me, and after 15 minutes it got collapsed. And I can't do anything, literally saying that I can't do anything rather than starting this treatment. So this is the dreaded condition. I hope all our prayer will go to the God and we can be savior from this COVID-19 stage. Thank you.